Welcome to AminAcademy.com. In fluid mechanics, let us discuss about condition for equilibrium of stability of a completely submerged bodies. Consider a balloon which is completely submerged in air. Let the lower portion of the balloon contains heavier material so that its center of gravity is lower than its center of buoyancy. Here, first condition will do stable equilibrium. Here, consider a balloon. A balloon and the lower portion is fixed with little heavier material. So, here, look, suppose the center of gravity is here, then center of buoyancy is here. Therefore, from this force, buoyancy force, here gravitational force, that is equal W. That is, in stable equilibrium, let the weight of the balloon is W. The weight W is acting through G vertically in the downward direction, while the buoyant force FB is acting vertically up through B. For the equilibrium of the balloon, W equal FB. Suppose at same time, suppose we are giving little angular displacement, we are giving to here little angular displacement, like in this, for that here the same balloon, consider like here, little angular displacement is given. Due to that, point B is here, point W. Here FB is acting vertically upward and W acting vertically downward. After that disturbance is given, then it comes to original position like this. It's called a stable equilibrium. Now, for an unstable equilibrium, here also W equal to FB, that is weight of the balloon is equal to buoyant force, and B and G are at the center of buoyancy B is below. Center of buoyancy Suppose consider this balloon. G is here and B is here. FB is upward and W is downward. That means this is an example for unstable equilibrium. Here also we are giving small disturbance, angular disturbance, so it gives like G is here, W acting downward, and B is here, point of buoyancy, center of buoyancy. So FB is acting upward. In unstable equilibrium, here W equal to FB, but the center of buoyancy B is below. Center of buoyancy is below of the center of gravity G. The body is in unstable equilibrium as shown in figure this one. A slight displacement to the body, like a slight angular displacement, is given. Thus, the body does not return to its original position, and hence the body is unstable equilibrium. Here, after giving angular displacement and small angular disturbance, but it won't come to like its original position. It's called a unstable equilibrium. Here, in stable equilibrium, after releasing the disturbance, angular disturbance, it come to original position. But in unstable equilibrium, it won't come to original position. Then neutral equilibrium is here. In neutral equilibrium, also FB equal W equal to FB, and W and the B and G are at the same point. Means here, consider a circular body like both B and G act through same point. That means it's a the body is said to be neutral equilibrium if body neutral equilibrium that point B and G act through the same point. Means buoyancy force FB upward, this is W downward. Here, these are the three conditions for state of equilibrium, that is stable equilibrium, unstable equilibrium, and neutral equilibrium. Now let us discuss about stability of floating bodies. The stability of floating body is determined from the position of the metacenter M. In case of floating body, the weight of body is equal to the weight of liquid displaced. We know that first in stable equilibrium, if the point M is above G, here consider a floating body. Like here, W the point G is here, point B is here. If B act upward, W act downward. Means here also, that means in stable equilibrium, G is upward, B is down. Then metacenter M, metacenter M is above G. M is above G. Here, in this, suppose if you are giving a slight disturbance, angular disturbance, like here, the point G W act downward, and meta center point M is here. Then from that meta center, point B1 is here. That FB if a slight angular displacement is given to the floating body in clockwise direction, the center of buoyancy shift from B to B1, center of buoyancy, suppose center of buoyancy here B2, then B here B in floating, after disturbance, angular displacement disturbance through clockwise direction, that point B slightly changes the position here. Here also FB act upward, weight acting downward. Now this is a stable equilibrium. In unstable equilibrium, consider this figure here. G is here because some weight is more in upside, so G is here and B is here. Then after giving small angular disturbance, the point G is here and point B, and it comes through B dash, slightly changes, and through FB act upward, and W downward. Suppose if a slight angular displacement is given to the floating body in the clockwise direction, the center of buoyancy shift from B to B dash, B to B1, and weight such that the vertical line through B1 cuts M meta center. Therefore, the point, so this is a point meta center is here. That's meta center. Then the buoyant force FB through B1 and weight W through G constitute a couple acting in anti-clockwise series. Because of this disturbance, because of the points changes, it's a couple acting anti-clockwise direction, and thus bringing the floating body in the original position. Here in stable equilibrium, after giving a disturbance, it comes to original position. But in unstable position equilibrium, after giving a small disturbance to the through clockwise direction, but it comes to because of this clock disturbance, after finishing the displacement, it comes to original position, and here it won't come to original position, so it's called unstable equilibrium. In stable equilibrium, after giving disturbance, it comes to original position. But in unstable equilibrium, after giving anti-clockwise direction disturbance, and because of that, it overturning couple acted, and it won't come to the original position. It's called unstable equilibrium. In neutral equilibrium, if the point M is at the center of gravity, M is at the center of gravity, of the body, the floating body will be in neutral equilibrium. The floating body body will be in neutral equilibrium. Here we'll do all the things in simple manner one more time. Here, stability of submerged bodies, here this is in stable equilibrium, is like that. That is, G is down at to B, and unstable equilibrium, G is upward and B is downward. In neutral equilibrium for stable submerged bodies is both B and G at the same point. If B is upward, W is downward. Here in stable equilibrium, after giving a disturbance, it comes to original position, but unstable equilibrium, it won't come to original position. Stability of floating bodies. Here, look at this floating body. Consider here, water level is this much. A metacenter M is above G. Metacenter is G, that means on this vertical line itself. Somewhere else M above G. And after giving a small disturbance, that it comes like, that means it comes to small changes in angular position and comes to original position. In unstable equilibrium, after giving a small disturbance in clockwise direction, but it won't come to original position. In neutral equilibrium, the position M, that is the point M, meta center M, is at the center of gravity. That is, both points coincide of the body. The floating body will be in neutral equilibrium. We have done. Please subscribe our YouTube channel.